Day two, reconstruction. So as I said, I'd have to nip off the little counterweight that was on there. So I did that with the trusty torch. When I pulled the converter out to knock it off, I noticed that the fluid spilt out, and it looks beautiful. Nice and clean and red, and no smellies. So we're all set, except that I had to change over those two little levers, change over the park switch. It's a different connector. Now the only problem is I can't use the same fittings to have the transmission cooler lines hooked up because these ones are bigger. Oh well, I gotta buy new fittings to go on there. They won't screw into the block. And of course I still gotta get a longer drive shaft. But anyways, we're ready to slam that bitch back together and put her in. Also, it has a brand new front seal. That's good too. So, wish me luck. Oops, I almost forgot. I have to take the cutting wheel grinder and make a notch just like that one in the other tranny, of course, for the crank position sensor. I'll do that right now. Now one more thing before we slam this thing back in. Just remember to show you guys a trick that I always use. A drill, a screwdriver, and a drywall screw. I always drill a little hole and just put a drywall screw in so the torque converter doesn't fall out part way while I'm wrenching this thing on. Because if it does, well then you got to take it back off and wiggle it and get it to fall back in all the notches again. And I know it's all the way in the right distance now, so we're all set. Once it's got a couple bolts in, just undo the screw and throw it away. Well, the tranny's in, but just a few bolts holding it up. Took three guys because I got no tranny jacker stand. Don't do this job kind of job very much. Wasn't too difficult. Now to crawl back underneath and put those four torque converter bolts in. Then jack it up and put a cross member on and start throwing everything back together. Now I did take a look at the truck in the forest, and the drive shaft's exactly the same length. And it fits this tranny, the drive shaft that came off this truck that won't even slide into the back of the tranny. Only difference is the mounting at the rear. On this truck, it's got a plate with four holes. The other truck in the forest has just got those two U-things that you strap down your U-joints with. So maybe I can just switch drive plates or take apart the back of the drive shaft on the other one. Well, I didn't video all the work we just got done doing, but the tranny is in. Now I have to bring it into the shop and make some custom fabricated rear tranny mounts so that it sits up high enough and attaches to the tranny support bracket, because it doesn't fit at all right now. It's just sort of laying and hanging there, and it's hanging way too low. Well, we're now back in the back 40, and we're going to see if we can get the drive shaft off that old 78 Dodge pickup truck, because it is the same length. But with the little changes, it looks like it might work. Definitely will fit the tranny, but so far it won't fit the rear end. Oh, I wish I had a tranny for that thing. Oh well. Now time to crawl underneath there. Huh. Spiders and ooh and goo and yuck and guck. Who knows what's under there? Oh well. Well, there's the difference. See? It's got two cups that drive the U-joints. Well, we'll get her off and see what we can do. Well, the shaft is off, and I'm sure you've already corrected me in your comments. It's an 86. And I am. It's a warm summer's night, why not? Well, let's go back and see what we can do. Jury rig something together, make it work. Middle of nowhere, I gotta make something work. Oh, that Dodge is still working sweet. It's fast. It's got a 5-speed. Beer bugs are tremendous tonight. Almost there. Now first we gotta see if the yoke fits inside the tranny.
Well, as you can see, the yoke fits in the tranny, but
when I measured the length of the drive shaft, I measured the length of the drive shaft out of this truck. I never even thought that that's the wrong length. It has to be 2.5 inches longer.
So unless I can find some tubing with my dirty lens and extend this drive shaft, I'm out of luck for tonight. Oh well.